good news. We all have a new brain cell, and it's looking like this particular kind of brain cell could be unique to humans. Do you feel smarter yet? Well, you're about to, because we're going to talk about your brain, which it turns out science actually knows very little about. We're just starting to scratch the surface, and mapping the brain is a far greater challenge even than mapping the human genome. But let's go over some basics. Your brain is full of cells, neurons, and glia. We're going to focus mainly on neurons, which are the messengers of information. Neurons communicate with each other and with the rest of your nervous system through electrical and chemical signals, and they're supported by glial cells. There are three main kinds of neurons: sensory neurons, which communicate information from your senses to your brain; motor neurons, which help you control your body's movements; and interneurons, which help motor neurons and sensory neurons talk to each other. And within these categories, neurons can be either excitatory or inhibitory. As their name suggests, excitatory neurons pass information along to other neurons, while inhibitory neurons can slow down excitatory action and stop other neurons from firing, controlling the flow of information in the brain. And the big news is that we've found a new kind of interneuron called the Rosehip cell, sitting right there in this vast unknown universe that lives inside our own heads. What's particularly exciting about this new research is that scientists are starting to use novel methods to delve into the brain. Recent advances in RNA analysis techniques called transcriptomics allow us to see more detail than ever before about how the brain works. A group at the Allen Institute for Brain Science in Seattle used these RNA sequencing techniques to identify unique gene expression patterns in frozen brain tissue. And meanwhile, a partner research team in Hungary used more traditional slice and dice lab imaging techniques on live brain tissue taken from brain surgery patients to see evidence of a cell that matched the genetic markers found by the Seattle group. And ta-da, a brand new brain cell type observed. So how does it affect human behavior? We're not quite sure yet. The Rosehip neuron appears to act as an inhibitory neuron. It's called the Rosehip neuron because it looks like the plant, and its specialized shape with rosehip-like bulges on its axons may help it act on the brain in a particular way. Lots more research is needed to discover the effect of Rosehip neurons on human behavior and cognition. But there are early hopes that as a neuron that controls information flow in the brain, it could be a key part of understanding intellectual disability and neuropsychiatric diseases like schizophrenia. Perhaps the most important part of this discovery, though, is that so far, we haven't been able to find the same kind of brain cell in the mouse brain. We rely on mice to study everything from cancer to pharmaceutical development to Alzheimer's, so this lack of an analogous structure in the rodent brain highlights how different the two really are. This discovery in particular points out important gaps that may result from trying to study human brain function in mouse models. We're making valuable progress in the vast unknown frontier of our brains, but there's still a heck of a long way to go. Does your brain hurt from all the knowledge? Subscribe to Seeker so we can guide you through all the brain learning. And fun fact, there's a project in the US called the Brain Initiative, which stands for Brain Research Through Advancing Innovative Neurotechnologies, and is dedicated to improving our understanding of the human brain. Thanks for watching.